Last week I told you how mankind lost their spiritual authority to Satan through Adam's sin, and then how Jesus won that authority back through his sinless death and gave that authority to all his children. And that means you. This week I want to tell you some of the ways to use that authority. Now in 2 Corinthians 10 and verse 4, it says, "The weapons we fight with are not the weapons of this world. On the contrary, they have divine power to demolish strongholds." So that means that you have access to powerful spiritual weapons that actually terrorize and disarm the kingdom of darkness. So of course, they don't want you to know what they are, and they certainly don't want you to use them. So I want to tell you about some of them today so you can start using them. Now, the first one that you have actually already used is repentance. That was the way you entered the kingdom. Is through repentance, you left the kingdom of darkness, entered the kingdom of light, and then with repentance, you broke off the chain of sin so that Satan could not continue to magnify that sinful behavior. And then once you're a Christian, if we all have problems with sin after we're in the kingdom, and whenever you sin, Satan says, of course, well, there I have an opportunity. They're sinning, I can magnify that and take control of them or influence them again. And every time you repent, once you're in the kingdom, you frustrate Satan's desire to magnify and perpetuate that sin. Then the next most powerful spiritual weapon is forgiveness. Because every time you forgive, you frustrate Satan's attempt to grow a bitter root inside you, to infiltrate your mind so that you're always stirred up and angry and thinking negatively. Then another spiritual weapon is blessing. You see, whenever you bless someone, you actually release the Holy Spirit to them, and that, of course, frustrates the demon that's trying to attack that person. They have to back off whenever you have released the Holy Spirit to them. Also too, when you bless others, it frustrates the demon attacking you that wants you to be so angry and resentful about what's happening in front of you. When you bless your enemies, you give up the need for revenge and hatred. Now another spiritual weapon is thankfulness. Because when you're thankful, not only does that bless the other person that you're thanking, but it frustrates spirits of greed and jealousy that want to make you ungrateful. And then worship. Worship is to me, the most enjoyable spiritual weapon. Because when you worship, you draw close to God and you bring the presence of God into your situation. Well, that's like demon repellent. They can't stand to be around worshipers. So every time you worship, when you're in a tense or difficult or oppressive situation, they have to flee. They hate it. They don't want to be around you. And loving other people. You see, when you love other people, of course it blesses them, but you reveal God's heart to them, and that frustrates Satan's plan for them and for you. And of course, prayer is a powerful spiritual weapon. I'll talk about that on another video. But you see, you have access 24 hours a day to all of these like nuclear spiritual weapons that completely frustrate Satan's plan for your life and the plan of his plan for others. So I want to encourage you, start being aware of what these weapons are, realize how easy they are to use, and start using them and see what difference it makes in your life and the situations you're facing right now. So now I want to hear from you. When you start using these spiritual weapons, what difference has it made in you and in others? Just leave your testimony in the box below, because it will encourage other people to begin using their weapons. If this is your first visit here, you need to get my free self-assessment guide. And to do that, just subscribe to my weekly email newsletter by completing the subscription form, which you can access by clicking on the link, Join the Transformation Movement. And I'll talk to you again next week, but this week, start using your spiritual weapons.